Students, this is a EVS class. Today we start a new chapter. Okay, but before that, as you see on the screen, plants picture. Students, as you know, plants are the base of nature, and I hope all of you very well know the importance of plants in our life. But students, do you all must have known how to plants grow and from where to plants originate? Yes, it's all because of seeds. So student, today we will study about seeds. Okay, chapter 5, seeds and seeds. First, what is a seed? Seed is reproductive part of the plant. It means plants give new baby plants with the seed. These are some example of seeds. Next is parts of seed. Okay. First part, as you see, first part is a seed coat. Seed coat means outer layer of the seed. Second part is embryo. Embryo is a new baby plant. Third part is leaves. And the another last part is fourth part, food storage. Okay. Next, first part of seed, that is embryo, grows into the baby plant. Second part, cotyledon stores food for the embryo. This part is also called food storage. And third, seed coat protects the inner part. Okay. Next is types of seeds. First type of seed is smooth seed. Example of smooth seed is carrot. This is the example of carrot seed. This is second type, rough seed. Example of rough seed, gram. This is the picture of gram. Third is flat seed. Example, pumpkin. This is the picture of pumpkin seeds. Next is things that are generally soaked in water, like nuts, rice, gram, pulses. Soaking chana or gram in water before cooking. Why soaking? So student, soaking helps the seed to absorb water and makes its seed coat softer. It makes the cooking easier and quicker. That's why we soak something before cooking. Next is, this is the process of soaking. Take some beans, right? Okay, the seeds absorb water and the seed coat becomes soft. And last, remove the seed coat and open the seed. Okay, next is, what are the sprouts? Do you know it? So dear students, when a seed gets moisture and warmth, the embryo uses the stored food in the cotyledon to grow into a sprout or baby plant. This process is called sprouting. Okay. Next is health benefits of sprout. First benefit, it helps shed fat. Second, it boosts your metabolism. Metabolism means your muscles and bones. Next benefit, it helps in the prevention of cancer. Next, it helps in better digestion. Digestion part we will already learn in the previous class, previous chapter. And last benefit is, it prevents anemia. Anemia means blood problems. Okay. Next is the process of germination. Student, you see, first we take one seed and put inside the moist soil. After that, seed grow in small, slowly. And the last, the plant, new baby plant, grown it properly. So steps of the germination. When a seed is sown into moist soil means wet soil, it begins to grow. This process is called germination. Steps of germination is, first step, the seed cord splits. Second step, our tiny roots grows downwards and our shoot rose upwards. Third, this produces a seedling of a plant which ultimately grows into a new plant. Fourth, after some time, the plant bears flowers. The flowers produce fruits and the fruits have seeds in them. Last step, all seeds can germinate when shown in moist soil under suitable conditions to produce new plants. So what is the conditions? So new condition for germination of sun seed. First condition, sunlight. Second, seeds require air. Third, seed require water. Fourth, seed require soil. So these are the condition for germination of seed. A seed requires sunlight, air, water and soil for germination. Okay, so student, I hope all of you understood today's concept. Okay, thank you.